Hey everybody, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at some proxies for some representative Bionicle 2015 sets. These are all wrong. These are not replicas of the actual sets. Anybody looking at these and looking at the official pictures like I am right now off screen can immediately see all the things that are wrong about these. So I'm not going to focus on all the things that are wrong about these. Just know that they are all wrong. They're simply representative proxies to show the relative size and to start getting us to understand what the feeling is of just having a number of these things in front of us. Some of the sets now have official box art that's high quality, that's been leaked out by vendors who have no respect for LEGO's date embargoes for upcoming products. And then those pictures have been copied by other folks and put on their blogs and YouTube videos and all over the place to say, hey, come look, I've got the pictures. No, I've got the pictures. No, I've got the pictures. So if you search for Bionicle 2015, you'll find a million copies of these pictures out there, including high quality ones with no confidential stamp going across them, actual official released pictures that aren't supposed to be released yet, but they are out there. And they're everywhere, much to the chagrin of LEGO. So what I've presented here is a representative protector figure, a representative medium-sized Toa figure, and then also the Lord of the Skull Spiders, and kind of a proxy for a Skull Spider. And I have gotten the sizes of these things pretty well captured, relatively speaking. So you can see just how much of a difference there is between a protector figure, which is kind of like a medium-sized, or yeah, I'd say a medium-sized Matoran kind of thing. And then the Toa, and this is not even one of the, representing one of the larger Toas, this is representing Gali, and much, much larger. Here we are down at ground level to give you a better comparison. It's kind of like the relationship during the Toa Fantoka line of the original Bionicle series. And you know, you can just imagine one of these backpacking on the back of one of the Toa. One of the interesting things about this new series for 2015 and beyond is that all of the major figures have actions built into them. So the little guys, the protectors, mostly have the new six-barreled shooters, which are stud shooters. They're small, all new pieces, and they will be used in different lines. And those are able to actually shoot things out without you know, grabbing things by hand and pushing them. So that's something that the little guys get. But then the larger figures mostly have kind of Toa Mata style actions with gears built into the back. So for instance, I've kind of taken what I saw of the mechanism from Lua, from Toa Lua, and kind of mixed it in with this Gali proxy here. But the general idea is that you've got a thing on the back that's going to allow you to move the arms in opposite directions. And that's always just built into the back. And you can see what I did here in this case. I've got it sticking out way too far. It does not look good. I think it may actually stick out almost that far with the new pieces. I think they have a new piece, a new lift arm piece, a new 90 degree lift arm piece to bring that in a little bit closer. But from the pictures that I saw, you know, you can only see one angle from each, but it looks like they might be sticking out pretty far. This particular character, Gali, would not have these bones sticking up. But again, I said I wouldn't focus on all the things that are wrong with these proxies here. But the general idea is that you will be able to have arms moving and have striking actions. Might be a little bit more friction in there. That remains to be seen. Also with Gali, it looked like you've got the ability to change the tail end of her weapon and take those pieces off and use them for flippers for her feet for when she's going underwater. Lord of the Skull Spiders is going to be built something like this and look something like this. I do believe that the front pairs of legs are connected like that from what little I was able to glean from the one angle. Just saw little bits of hints that suggest that that's how those are connected together. Why didn't I use this piece instead for the head? Well, I tried it and this one just looked better because at least there's an eye or something that kind of looks like an eye there. However, what is not captured here at all is the mechanism for this one. So I believe this one's going to have a leaping mechanism. So back here, again with the 90 degree lift arm kind of adapter pieces that look like they're new for the new series. There's going to be built in there. Again, the four lobed gear shows up somewhere. We see a little bit of a preview of it on the side. And I believe that this thing is going to have a leaping action, or at least a kind of a striking action with at least a pair of the legs, if not both front pairs together. So that'll be interesting to see and definitely add some interest to this otherwise pretty plain, pretty straightforward thing. The legs are definitely made relatively rigid in here. It's a little bit surprising to me that they didn't use ball joints through here. They did use the Technic lift arms, but I think that's just to help facilitate the action for when the legs are gonna move based on what you do back here. I think the knob will be back here for activating that. So by keeping some of these joints rigid, it allows that to work more effectively. And kids that kind of are rough with the stuff when they're playing in battles are not gonna have as much trouble with the joints kind of getting all folded up on themselves. So it's kind of a compromise there, a little bit positive, a little bit negative. Again, the skull spiders are gonna be something like these little things, just five pieces, one central piece with a new mold that's gonna look more like a skull than this, obviously. And then four of the legs, these exact same legs. So there's kind of the relative size there between those, but there's not gonna be anything else to those. I don't know if we're gonna be able to use these pieces for anything else. I'm sure that they will be very useful for mock makers, but I don't know if there will be an official use for the skull spider carapace pieces. So that's it for this video. I just wanted to bring these proxies into frame all at the same time to start to give folks who are interested in the theme an idea of what the sizes are going to be like and the general textures of the figures. When the rumors started to get a little bit more real originally for Bionicle for 2015 coming back, I did post up my thoughts about it on the blog. I slightly updated those thoughts after it was truly confirmed that they were coming, and now that we have the official images out, I've got another post up giving my full thoughts. So if you want to hear the rest of my thoughts and how those thoughts have evolved as we've gotten more information, you can find that all on my blog at jangbrickks.com. And of course, I believe it goes without saying, once the official sets come out and become available to the public, I will buy them and I will review them. Until then, of course, I'm gonna keep doing what I do, reviewing other stuff and building custom mocks. So I hope that you'll stick around, and I'll be talking to you again soon.